Well, thank you, Megan. It's always my pleasure to be here. I think that why Tai Chi and MCI? I think that it's very important to be able to engage and to be present in your body as you navigate some of the trials and the challenges of MCI. I think that Tai Chi teaches this sort of engagement through the coordination of breath, movement, focus, and balance. At the core of everything that we do is in Tai Chi, in Qigong as well, is balance. Today, I'd like to focus on one of the basic Qigong forms that we've been learning over the year, the Bao Dao Jin, which is translated as the Eight Silk Brocade. It's called the Eight Silk Brocade because it's the movements, the silky, the slow and engaging movements remind you of silk fabric. As always, we want to just open up the gates so that, again, the energy will flow. Now, even as we begin our warm-up, which should be, again, coordinating movement, breath, focus. We're not thinking about other things right now. We're just simply focusing on the area of the body that we're manipulating. And as always, as we begin to move, we realize that everything's connected. So in order to relax one area of the body, you've got to relax all adjacent areas. Using our internal focus, we're able to do that. Pushing into the earth, our movement begins at the soles of the feet. We talk about balance. Our balance begins at the soles of the feet. So our feet should be relaxed, open. I say open like the duck's feet, so that we can feel for balance as we move. Again, engaging the entire body, focusing the mind, so that we never overextend or underextend, and we can move comfortably, soft inside, loose outside. And we're breathing. Pushing into the earth to create the momentum, the point where the balance, our balance begins. If we don't have balance in the soles of the feet, we cannot have balance anywhere above. So, Tai Chi and Qigong teach this intentionality to be very connected, very aware of our movement. So we're pushing down. And as we push up, we're going to stack the vertebrae in the spine. Hands on the hips, feet shoulder width apart. We're going to push down and allow the upper torso to circle as we breathe. Relaxing the hips, lower back, glutes. Let's go ahead and circle center. And pushing down, let's go in the opposite direction. Noticing, as always, what needs to yield internally. It's the inside that gives. Moving as if we were connected by rubber bands. And we're going to be careful never to move any faster, as I mentioned, then we can breathe comfortably and feel balance. So let's go ahead and circle to center. Again, hanging, arms loose, head loose, letting the weight of the arms and the head stretch out the neck and the shoulders and push down to come to a vertical position. Now standing comfortably, let's just take a few seconds, and we can place palm over palm for women, left over right, men over in the opposite direction, right over left. Just get a feel of that inner energy. Feeling the chi beginning to move. However chi presents to you. And we're going to shift the weight from palm to heaven, palm to earth, opening up the side, opening up the rib cage. And of course, as we cross our center of gravity, we're going to sink down. Notice what needs to yield. Don't fight the muscles. Coordinating breath and movements. Relax the shoulder, relax the neck. And feel for balance throughout. Breathing in. Breathing out, and this time, as we circle to center, arm fingertips to heaven. And allow the arms to flow down, head to flow forward. We're going to allow the head to roll like the marble in the slot. Relax the jaw. Just let the tongue rest on the roof of the mouth. Breathing. And let's circle back to center. And push up to a vertical position. There are many different types of qigong forms. I think of them as just the smaller packages because you receive the same benefit as you do from longer forms or even the Tai Chi form itself. And that is the generating and moving the energy. All right. So let's go ahead and begin our eight silk brocade. Let's begin by just standing comfortably, hands on the dantian. And let's just do some breathing exercises, wave breathing. Arms float out, we breathe in. Breathing in through the nose to clean the air. Knees soften, arms float in. And it's called wave breathing because it mimics the waves at the seashore, at the ocean front. Waves go out, they come in. We breathe into the pit of the stomach, bottom of the stomach, into the chest as well. Let the body expand. Never using force. Again, simply being soft inside, loose outside. And float down. All right. So let's go ahead and we're going to shift our bodies and arms are like ropes, just shaking off any excess tension that we have been holding. We're always holding internal tension. So as we move, as we breathe, again, we just want to be soft inside, loose outside, and disperse this energy. Now, as I shift naturally, I sink down, never resisting, always yielding. Looser and looser. Relax that lower back, glutes. As we sink down, we feel that stretch through the hip, through the groin, through the inner thigh. Looser and gradually let's come back to center. So the acyl brocade is one of the standing qigong forms. So we won't be doing a lot of stepping or moving, but even as we stand, as we transfer the weight, one of the 10 essentials of Tai Chi is to transfer the weight empty to full. We want to always feel for balance. All right? So standing comfortably, very important. Again, our feet are open, our knees are soft. We have a tendency, to hold tension in the lower back. To release that tension, we want to sink into the legs and tuck the tip of the coccyx forward as if we're sitting on a high stool. We want to maintain the crown to heaven so we can access the energy that supports us coming down from above. Feet are open so that we can access the energy that supports us coming from below, from the earth. There's energy around us at all times. We just disconnected from it. This is our opportunity to reconnect. And as we move as if we're moving through water, engaging with this energy that supports us, that's always around us. Okay? So the first of our eight silk brocade is called Two Arms Holding Up the Earth. Arms float up, palms float up to turn out. I said earth, but I meant sky. Two arms holding up the sky, and arms circle out fully. Always breathing. Again. Allowing the body to elongate. Always coordinating movement and breath. Let the breath come and go as it needs to. Moving as if moving through water. Knees are soft. Sink down even more as you stretch up. Always connected to your body. And one last time, sinking down, extending up at the same time, and arms float out, floating through water. All right. Standing comfortably. Let's just cultivate the energy for a few seconds, focusing on the feeling, again, however qi presents to you. Every time we exhale is the opportunity to release tension. Tension that we, as I mentioned, we may not have been even aware that we're holding. All of us hold tension in different areas of the body. One of the areas in the jaw, we tend to clamp the jaws together. So let the tongue just rest lightly on the roof of the mouth to relax the jaw. All right. Our next posture of the eight silk brocade, we want to space the feet even further into the bow stance. This is called shooting the bow. And if you've ever done any archery, you know the feeling of pulling the bow to release the arrow. Arms float up. Palm turns out. We make two fingers. Eyes follow the two fingers, pulling the bow. and comes back. And breathing in. Again, we extend up. Exhaling, releasing. And whatever we do on one side of the body, we want to do on the other for balance. Pull the bow. Not limiting your movement, but then again, not using force. Okay, feet are open. The earth underneath us to support us. Knees are soft. Notice what muscles, tendons, ligaments need to yield and allow them to do so. And again, we're going to stretch up. To slow down. All right, relax the legs, relax the hips if you need to. And just take a few seconds and notice whether there are still areas of the body that you're holding tension in. If you are, just simply take that deep cleansing breath into that area, breathing in through the nose. And as you exhale, release any discomfort. Do that as many times as you need to feel relaxed. Okay, let's continue. Now, as far as balance is concerned, we are always, again, crown to heaven, soles of the feet to earth. We're always supported. But we're always also, not only from the energy coming up from the earth, but from the energy from above that allows us to stand as if suspended by a cord. We're not crunching the body. We're not slumped forward. We're not rigid and using force, but we allow that upward pull, the body to engage with that upward pull so that we can stand balanced and comfortable. Okay, our next of the eight silk brocade is called Stork Flashes Wings. Stork stretches and flashes wings. So again, palms float up. And notice how natural it is to breathe in as we in and breathe out. One arm floats down, the other floats up. Fingertips to palm to the heavens, and the stork stretches away. Palm to heaven and stork stretches wings other side. Remind yourself to let that other arm float down. As one arm floats up, the other floats down, extending. Taking this time to breathe in, to breathe out. Arm floating through water and float down. And relax your legs and hips if you need to. And let's cultivate the energy just for a few seconds. The next of our eight silk brocade is Owl Looks Behind. So stand comfortably, feet shoulder width apart. And as the arms float up, palms turn out, head follows. Opening up the front of the body, relaxing the shoulders, upper back. Pushing down. Not using force, not limiting your movement. Feeling the point at which the movement ceases. Let the head follow. Knees should be soft. So that as we push into the earth, the momentum, the energy travels up the legs, through the core, out through the fingertips. Breathing in, letting the body expand like the balloon. And let all of the air out of your balloon. And one more. And arms float down. All right, relax in your feet, relax in your legs. And let's cultivate the energy. Just focusing on the feeling. We feel the chi moving a little bit stronger now. Moving like the river. Transporting energy to wherever the body needs it. We don't have to know. Okay, let's go on to our next movement. Feet are a little bit wider. Hands turned out on the knees, looking out. And we're going to sink down into a squat and pushing into the earth. We're going to push up, looking over the toe. Sinking down. Circle down. We don't have to fully extend. Don't lock the knees. Always breathing, taking your time, feeling for balance. Our feet are open. The earth supports us. It's called swing right, swing left. Relax the hips. Breathing. Feeling for balance within your body, never moving in a way that creates imbalance. We feel threatened. We're unbalanced, we tend to tighten up. So we want to remain soft inside, loose outside. Always breathing. Relax the shoulders. Coordination of the upper and lower circles. Pushing down, don't try to pull up with the back, push into the earth. And one more. Feet are open. Feel for balance. Push down. Relax the shoulders. Let the spine turn. And we're going to circle down. Back to center. And pushing into the earth again to come back to a vertical position. Shift your weight and just relax your legs, hips, and breathe. And arms float down. Okay, our next posture is going to be similar to our warm-up, push heaven, push earth. We're going to just separate the feet, shoulder width apart, looking out, arms loose. And as one arm floats up, the other pushes down. Palm to heaven, palm to earth. Breathing in to breathe out. Breathing in to breathe out. Tongue resting, jaw relaxed, feet open, knees soft. Relaxing, breathing into pit of the stomach, the lower abdomen, body expanding. Notice where your mind is. Bring it back to the movement and the feeling. If your legs become fatigued, sink down a little bit more. Relax the legs. Breathing in, nice full inhalation. Nice full exhalation. And one more. Arm floats up. And float down. And relax. Strengthening the muscles, tendons, and ligaments. For total body vitality. Cultivating the energy. Just enjoying the feeling. And float down. Okay, in our final posture, we're going to allow the arms to float up, fingertips to heaven, feet are just shoulder width apart comfortably. Legs are straight on this. We lean forward, fingertips touch the toes. Knees soften, allowing the arms to float up as if floating on water. To float in And arms float down as the legs extend, pushing into the earth. Do not pull up with the back. And up. Relax to breathe in. And relax to breathe out. Feeling that in the back of the leg, hamstring. Knees soften. Back straightens. Arms float in. Elbows down. Arms float down. Pushing into the earth. Pushing down. Become vertical. Staying connected to your body. Push down, arms float down, legs extend. And arms slow down. And standing comfortably, cultivating the energy. Enjoying. Now we really feel that energy moving as it should. Again, chi presents differently to everyone. It may be a pulsation, a tingling, a warmth, or maybe a feeling of being a little bit more alive. We feel it now, the energy radiating from the energy vault, the dantian, that area, an inch and a half below the navel, up through the core, down through the arms, out through the fingertips, down through the legs, through the soles of the feet. So you should feel a little bit warmer, a little bit more invigorated. So let's go ahead and pull up a chair. All right, and sit towards the front of the chair, please. So your feet are flat. And just let your palms, your hands rest on the knees, palms facing. Crown to heaven, feet open to the earth. Let the chair hold you up. And just breathe and enjoy the feeling. So when we go through our forms, through our movements, we bring the energy to the surface of the body. Before we end, we want to seal it in the body. Palms towards the face. We're going to focus on the feeling as we move the energy up and out over the sides of the face, touching or not touching. Just focus on that energy, the radiating from the palms. There's certain areas of the body that we can definitely feel the energy radiate from, and the palms are one of them. using three fingers. Just let the head rest forward. And as you breathe, massage the temples and notice where the mind is. First, we massage one direction and then we massage the other. Using the fleshy tips of the finger, relax the jaw completely. And let's massage the muscles around the mouth and up the jaw. Just let the jaw be slack. Using the thumb and the index, we're going to pluck the ears and pull. Sandwiching the earlobe between the fingers as we pull from top to bottom. Notice whether you're holding your breath. Come back, let the breath come and go as it needs to. And placing the thumb at the base of the ear, we're going to push up the crease behind the ear from bottom to top several times to invigorate heart function. We're going to let the elbow rest in the palm, come to the inside of the neck. We're going to squeeze like we're squeezing water from a sponge, from inside out, releasing that tension that we have a tendency to hold in this area of the body, and relaxing the arm and the leg. We want to circle the shoulder joint, massaging the shoulder. And coming to the outside of the arm, stretch the arm out, and we want to squeeze the energy through the arm and out through each of the fingers. Okay, let's do the other side. Just let the head rest and squeeze. Relax. Blinking the fingers, let's push in just a bit. Massage in between the fingers. And relax the fingers. And relax the wrist. Not using force. Let the wrist circle. First one direction. And then the other. Elbows remain down, don't create tension. Soft inside, loose outside. And shake it out. And we're gonna use those fingers to tap the kidneys. As we breathe. Stimulating energy. We're going to place the palms over the kidneys, feeding energy into the kidney area. And moving the energy down the side of the leg to the heel, around the foot, and up the front. We're going to seal the energy in the leg. always breathing and staying connected to your body. Palms on the dantian, crown to heaven, feet to earth. We're going to start with a small circle. We're going to allow that small circle to gradually expand as we breathe. Stomach soft. And we're going to let that large circle gradually contract. Until we find the palms resting on the dantian, feeding energy, using the mind to feed energy into the dantian, the energy vault. We should feel our abdomen move soft and moving like the baby's. All right, bringing the palms, hands turned out at the knee. We're going to bring the weight of the body forward until we lift up off the chair, pushing into the earth. Torso hanging, chin on the chest. I'm going to get to one last time. We're going to stack the vertebrae in the spine as we push up to a vertical position. Arms float up. Float in. We're going to bring the energy to the palms. And push down. Arms circle up. Knees soften. Stomach soft and moving. And breathe. Feel for balance. And shift the weight. And I salute you for your presence here this afternoon. I hope you feel a million times better than you did when we began. And all of these practices you can do on your own. Just do as much as you remember until we reunite for our Tai Chi journey. So thank you.